It's been said, and there's some rumors, rumblings out there online that supposedly the government are looking at implementing a third national lockdown in the UK to stem the spread of COVID-19. You know, ahead, I guess, after the Christmas break, which is insane if you think about it, right? We have this weird little grace period that they've sort of implemented where we can socialize and mix with different households for a 5-day period during Christmas, which, you know, a lot of people have rightfully called out and said is probably the wrong approach. But it seems like this government, the more you keep calling them out, the more you keep questioning their directives, the more you provide them with evidence that might counteract what they're trying to do, they just love to double down, you know, sort of anchor their feet into the ground and just keep on steaming through, which is, you know, I guess it's probably a mark of leadership, but sometimes in this scenario that we're in at the moment, it can be a bit frustrating. It can feel like you're sort of speaking into the void when it comes to what the government will go do with COVID. But again, the numbers do look scarily high. You know, I think the R naught number is above 1.5 last time I checked. There's this weird mutation that's sort of spreading across the southeast of England. So there's definitely issues that are in place here. But sometimes you look at these situations that we're in and you think to yourself, it's less about what we do in the next month, and it's more so about what we didn't do in the past 4 months, right? Why didn't we sort of, even the schools is a good thing, why didn't we wind down the schools a couple of weeks, or kind of, you know, lock them down for a couple of weeks before Christmas? Because usually, if you've ever been, you know, in sort of like secondary school especially, the couple of weeks before Christmas are basically you not doing anything, right? The teachers don't want to exert themselves because they can't wait to go home to their families. The kids are basically not even present. They'd already think about their presents. It's a complete non-event. They could have easily wind down the schools, closed them for 2 weeks before, you know, everyone kind of officially goes back home anyway, and then just extended the lockdown up until this date. Maybe still given a 5-day grace period, and then maybe open it up later on. But this whole, like, especially in London, where we were in tier two for like a week or maybe 2 weeks or something, people went completely crazy, went outside as you'd expect them to do, right? It's been locked indoors all day isn't the most humane and sensible way to go about these things. But people went out for the last 2 weeks, socialized, did their thing, and then suddenly now you're sort of like turning off the tap again. But the damage has been done for the most part, it feels like. But anyway, this is Boris Johnson basically expanding on it and kind of giving his vague non-answers that kind of lead you to believe that this further lockdown is probably coming. So brace yourselves if you're feeling negative.
Well, obviously, we're hoping very much that we'll be able to avoid anything like that. But the reality is that the rates of infection have increased very much in the last few weeks. Here, where I am in the northwest, in Bolton, they've actually done a fantastic job in bringing it down. If you look at what people have done in Greater Manchester, really heroic effort.
And if you're listening, the sound that is going is happening, that's not me, it's him wearing his flipping hybrid vest and moving his hands, you know, like a lunatic.
To get the disease under control. So what we're saying to people now over this Christmas period is, you know, think of those rules about the three households that you can bubble up with, the 5 days. That is very much a maximum. That's not a target people should aim for. And I think people really get this. People do get this. All the things I'm seeing, all the evidence I'm seeing, is people really understand this is the time to look after, think about our elderly relatives, avoid spreading the disease, keep it short, keep it small. You know, have yourselves a very little Christmas, as I said the other night. That is, I'm afraid, the way through this year.
Those little mantras that they sort of trot out are so, you know, I won't say demeaning, but they're so patronizing, isn't it? Smarter, smaller, simpler, merry little Christmas. Like, go fuck yourself, really. Anyway, and it kind of expands itself a little bit on here. What's going from the BBC, hoping to avoid a national lockdown. It says the following: the PM says he's hoping to avoid another national lockdown in England, but that the COVID-19 cases have increased very much in recent weeks. He chaired meetings on Friday, number 10, sources said, amid growing concerns about the spread of the COVID-19. Health bosses have warned the NHS is already under significant pressure, and nearly 90% of the beds in England are full, which is absolutely insane to think about. The government scientists are continuing to evaluate this new strain, and ministers have been discussing what action would be necessary to deal with it. Ask if the people were going to be told to rethink their Christmas plans, a Downing Street source said, "We are not there yet, but hold press." Development over the night, rumors were abound, and this dude on Twitter basically shared that supposedly sources tonight implying the Christmas bubble could be popped. He says, a caveat, a doubt decision made on this yet, but hearing much the same at all reportings of the Sun and the Telegraph. And if essentially the Sun and the Telegraph are reporting that they might be a bit of a change in terms of the Christmas bubble, and they might just scrap it in general, especially in the South, just because of what's been happening with the numbers going exponentially higher, which makes sense. Again, I think the Christmas thing was always a bit weird for me. I was always under the impression that it would make more sense to maybe ask the population, especially since most of us have been living under some level of restrictions for what, 8 months plus, in some cases 10, if you've kind of been aware of it since February, you've been living under some level of restrictions for 10 months or so. It would make more sense to be like, hey, population, instead of us celebrating Christmas, you know, the traditional way, why don't we just do it at home in our own abode and kind of share, you know, whatever we could, make it as fun as we can, with the idea that if we lock down and be serious now and don't go out and socialize, then we can possibly have a better new year going forward. But it just feels like with this approach, this kind of laissez-faire, hands-offy approach, wishy-washy vagueness that we have going on at the moment, more likely than not, we're going to be under, you know, numerous lockdowns in a new year, not only one. So if you're thinking, hey, that one in January is bad enough, definitely hold your braces, because for sure if that happens, there's going to be more coming down the more further down the line, which is really frustrating considering there's so many easy things that we could do now to kind of mitigate the spread of it, but you know, the government seem to be reluctant to do so. But hey, what can we do? Just report the news, just talk about these issues. There's nothing really we can do. Situation, this sort of reminds me of, like, you know, when you're at a house party somewhere, yacked off your face, they're talking about how you could fix the world's problems, isn't it, with bogey running down your nose somewhere. You think you've got all the answers, you think you know what is the solution, but sometimes things are probably a little bit more complicated than you really led to believe. You'd hope so, right? You'd hope there's probably a lot more that they're sort of considering that we're not really privy to, that's affecting the situation in place. I remember reading something about them, that's why they've been kind of mum on the whole vaccine thing. There's not really been a lot of talk about that. They haven't really given us any timelines of when the nation could get vaccinated and things, and kind of given something to aim for, because the idea is that they don't want to give people a false sense of security so they go out and be crazy, which is, you know, understandable. It's a bit of a wild thing to say, but it's understandable. So there's definitely some rationale behind these decisions, but just from a, you know, regular day, you know, average person on the street, it just doesn't make any sense, really, you know, to open things up then to close them down again, and then to open them up again just for Christmas, then to close them down again for the new year, is like so backwards it beggars belief. But hey, what can we do?